Welcome to this session on derivation for a reflection about line y is equal to mx plus c. In previous session, we have discussed composite transformation. What is my composite transformation? After a composite transformation, we have discussed various things like successive translation, then successive rotation, successive scaling. After that, we have discussed how to find rotation about pivot point, rotation about or scaling about the pivot point. Now, the last derivation from this chapter is derivation for reflection about line y is equal to mx plus c. Now, it is nothing but we have to find reflection about arbitrary line, any line y is equal to mx plus c. In case of reflection, we have four different types of reflection. We have, that is nothing but reflection about x-axis. So we know how to perform reflection about x-axis. The object is reflected from about x-axis. We know reflection about y-axis, how to reflect it about y-axis. Then we know how to reflect about line y is equal to x line, and how to reflect about line y is equal to minus x. But we don't have any matrix for reflection about line y is equal to mx plus c, means any arbitrary line. And that is our aim, to find out the matrix, composite matrix for reflection about line y is equal to mx plus c. Now see here, this is the suppose line with equation y is equal to mx plus c, and this is the object. This is the object we have, and that object we want to reflect about the line y is equal to mx plus c. But as I have told, there is no any matrix for reflection about any arbitrary line. So we have to convert, we have to use whatever available with us. So what we have with us, that is a reflection about x-axis, y-axis, it is available with us. So we can convert this line in terms of x-axis or y-axis, and then again we will take it back to the original position. So that is nothing but what we can use, or what we can do for this reflection about y is equal to mx plus c. So in case of reflection about y is equal to mx plus c, we have to perform some steps, as we have performed in pivot point rotation, few steps we did. Similarly, we can perform some steps for reflection about y is equal to mx plus c. So what are the steps required? The first step required is translate line along with the object, so that line will pass through origin. So what you have to do is, you have to translate this line by distance c, so that this line will be shifted to origin. So such line, you will get the line along with the object. So this is the first step you have to perform. After that, what is the second step you have to perform? You have to rotate the line and object with angle theta, so that the line will coincide with the x-axis. Now, line having some angle, if you translate it, this line having some angle theta, so if you rotate that line about origin, and then the line will coincide with x-axis. Line will coincide with x-axis. Then next is, you have to perform a reflection of object about x-axis. Now you have the x-axis, and we know the matrix for reflection about x-axis. So you can perform reflection about line means x-axis. Then after reflection, you need not to keep that object at the same place. You have to take it to the original position, means you have to perform inverse rotation by angle theta. Inverse rotation by angle theta. And then next, last is inverse translation, or translate back to the original position. So five steps required to perform the reflection about line y is equal to mx plus c. So that one by one I will tell you how to perform it. Suppose this is the line with equation y is equal to mx plus c. Suppose this is the line with equation y is equal to mx plus c. So what do you mean by c? C means it is a y-intercept. So this is a point called as c. So in first step, you have to translate the line along with the object, so that the line will pass through origin. Means you have to take that line that much distance back, so that this line may pass through the origin. Means how much distance you have to translate it back? By c distance. Means dy as a c, you have to take by that c distance, the line will coincide with the origin. So this is nothing but how it is shifted. If you shift, suppose this is the original line, y is equal to mx plus c. If you shift it by distance c, means if you translate to the origin, then this is nothing but a new location or new position of the object along with the line. This is the line with the object. So this is the first step we have. So for that first step, you can write the matrix for the translation. You can write it, the translation matrix. It is a translation matrix T1 0 0 0 1 minus C, because you are going backward, and then 0 0 1. So this is the first matrix you have. T is equal to 1 0 0 0 1 minus C 0 0 1. After translation, now next is, this is the angle theta. This is the angle theta the line is making with the x-axis, about x-axis. So you must rotate that line by angle theta so that the line will coincide over the x-axis, or it will lie on x-axis. Similarly, the object will be also rotated. So this is nothing but the second step. You have to rotate the line and object with the angle theta. This is the angle theta. Angle theta, so that the line coincide with the x-axis. So you can perform it. This is nothing but after rotation of a line by angle theta, the object as well as line will coincide with x-axis. So this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis. Now what is the matrix for rotation? For rotation matrix, as you are rotating in what clockwise direction? So clockwise rotation is considered as negative, so that our matrix will become cos theta sine theta 0 minus sine theta cos theta 0 0 0 1. So this is nothing but a rotation by angle theta. Rotation by angle theta. So first matrix we have, this is a translation matrix. Translation by distance c, so that the line will come to origin, and then to coincide with the x-axis, we must rotate that line clockwise by theta degree. So this is nothing but what we have. So after rotation, you can have the line with the along with the x-axis. Now, after having the line coinciding with the x-axis and object, third step you have to perform is perform reflection of object about x-axis. Now see here, if suppose this is the object, original object, you can perform reflection. This is a reflection of object about x-axis. And we have the matrix. We know the matrix of reflection, so that you can write it as Rx reflection is equal to, what is the matrix of reflection about x-axis, where x value remains same, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So means y value changes and x value remains same. Correct. So this is the reflection about x-axis matrix. Now once you perform the reflection, you have to take that object to the original position. So that is nothing but the fourth step, is you have to apply inverse rotation by angle theta. If you perform this, this is nothing but rotation performed by theta degree. It is the inverse rotation, and it is, you can call it as, it is the clockwise, anti-clockwise rotation. So that r theta inverse, you can write it as cos theta minus sine theta 0 sine theta cos theta 0 0 0 1. So this is the rotation matrix r inverse. So this is inverse rotation by angle theta. So cos theta minus sine theta 0 sine theta cos theta 0 0 0 1. After performing rotation, last step is you have to take the whatever axis we have by distance c towards the original position. So this is nothing but object along with the axis. You have to take it back to the by distance c. Now it is forward translation by distance, this much distance. It is the forward translation. So you can say t inverse is equal to 1 0 0 0 1 c 0 0 1. The backward translation. The how many matrices we have? We have this matrix, first matrix. It is a translation to the origin, so first matrix. Then we have rotation matrix. Then we have reflection matrix about x-axis. And then we have a rotation, back rotation. It is back rotation by angle theta. And last it is T inverse, that is nothing but back translation to the original point. Means there are total five matrices that we have to multiply together. So that composite matrix can be written as is equal to, we know that whatever operation we are performing last, the matrix should be written first. So that is our notation. So which operation performed last? This is the operation, means back translation. So you can write it as T inverse. So it is T inverse, then R theta inverse, then reflection with X axis, then rotation with theta angle, and last matrix, it is translation matrix. So all those five matrices you have to multiply to find out the composite matrix, correct? So this is the first translation, means back translation. As per our notation, whatever operation we are performing last, the matrix of that first return should be written first. So based on that, T inverse will be written first, then R theta inverse will be second, then Rx means reflection matrix third, then rotation, this is fourth, and last it is translation. So one by one, five matrices you have to write in this particular calculation of composite matrix. Now I can write it is equal to, what is that T inverse? 1 0 0 0 1 C 0 0 1 multiplied by rotation, it is cos theta minus sine theta 0 sine theta cos theta 0 0 0 1 multiplied by reflection. This is reflection about x axis, 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 0 1. Then back rotation, cos theta sine theta 0 sine theta minus sine theta, sorry, it is cos theta 0 0 0 1, and last it is translation, means 1 0 0 0 1 minus C 0 0 1. Now those are the five matrices we have, and for calculation of composite matrix, multiply first two matrices, then whatever answer you are getting, multiply with the third, then whatever answer you will get, multiply with the fourth, and last multiply with the fifth one. So this multiplication you have to perform one by one. Now we'll start with the multiplication of the first two. So is equal to first two, multiply, do the multiplication. 1 into cos theta, then 1 into minus sine theta, so it is minus sine theta, then 1, 1, 1, last it is 0, then 0 into cos theta, it is sine theta, 0 into this cos theta, 0 means C is 0, then 0, 0, 1. This is the multiplication of first two matrices. This to be multiplied with third one, 1, 0, 0, 0 minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, multiplied with next, that is cos theta minus sine theta, 0, it is plus sine theta, minus sine theta, cos theta, 0, 0, 0, 1, multiplied by 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus C, 0, 0, 1. Similarly, you can multiply those two matrices together. So those two, then whatever answer you are getting, you can multiply with the third next remaining, and then you have to find the composite matrix. So this is all about the matrix multiplication from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. So finally, you can write it as is equal to, what is the final matrix? So you will get the matrix after evolving, after solving everything, and after multiplication, the matrix is cos of cos of 2 theta sine of 2 theta, then it will be minus C sine of 2 theta sine 2 theta minus cos 2 theta C plus C cos 2 theta 0, 0, 1. So this is a matrix where you have to put this cos theta formula is cos square theta minus sine square theta. So this formula you have to use, as well as for cos sine 2 theta, it is cos theta sine theta plus sine theta cos theta. In multiplication, you have to use that two formulas to make it cos 2 theta and sine 2 theta. And finally, after all multiplication or after everything, you can have one more arrangement that cos 2 theta, you can write it as 1 minus tan square theta upon 1 plus tan square theta, as well as sin 2 theta, 2 tan theta, 1 plus tan square theta. So we know that m is equal to tan theta. So that cos 2 theta, you can put the values 1 minus m square upon 1 plus m square, and 2 tan theta is 2m divided by 1 plus m square. So finally, you can write the matrix 1 plus m square, 1 plus m square, then minus 2cm divided by 1 plus m square, then 2m, 1 plus m square, then m square minus 1 upon 1 plus m square, then 2c m square plus 1, then 0, 0, 1. So this is the final matrix we can have: 1 minus m square, 1 plus m square, 2m, m square plus 1, 1 plus m square, you can write minus 2cm, then 2m upon 1 plus m square. So this is the final matrix we have for the reflection about y is equal to mx plus c. So whenever they will ask for reflection about or derivation for reflection about line y is equal to mx plus c, you must begin from the first step. So that is nothing but this is the first drawing you have to do. After that, write down the reflection, means what are the steps required. So steps required are translate line along with the object so that line will pass through the origin. Then rotate line about object with angle theta so that line will coincide with the x-axis. Then perform reflection of object about x-axis. Then apply inverse rotation by angle theta. Then translate back to the original position. So this is how we can do this. And one by one step, first is translation. Translate along the line with the object so that line will pass through origin. So this is nothing but the first step. Then you can draw a second, that is rotate by angle theta. Then third is reflection. You have to write the reflection matrix about x-axis. Then apply inverse rotation. See, inverse rotation by angle theta. Now see, in this case, we have taken sine theta. This is taken because if you put here, rotation is clockwise direction. So that rotation is negative, means cos of minus theta is cos theta, and sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. And because of that, this value changes to sine theta and it becomes minus sine theta. Then reflection, then it is rotation by angle theta. Then it is the translation back to the original position, and finally multiply all those five and multiply first two, then with the answer with the third, answer with the fourth, like this. Multiply, you will get the answer in terms of cos square theta minus sin square. So because of that, the matrix will become cos 2 theta sin 2 theta minus sin 2 theta sin 2 theta minus cos 2 theta C plus cos 2 theta 0, 0, 1. Then cos 2 theta is 1 minus tan square theta, 1 plus tan square theta. Sin 2 theta is equal to 2 tan theta, 1 plus tan square theta. Put those values and finally you will get the matrix 1 minus m square, 1 plus m square, 2m, 1 plus m square, minus 2cm, 1 plus m square, 2m, 1 plus m square, like this. So all the values you will get. And this is nothing but the final matrix for reflection about line y is equal to mx plus c. So this is nothing but the completion of chapter. Thank you for joining.